year where a special policy was very cleverly handled by the British. It is known as Divisive Communal Gulf, DCG. And whatever the problems that we are facing now or we are going to face even after 100 years, that is only the contribution and blessing of that divide and rule policy. That has created the result of hatredness inside, communal clashes, caste divisions, bomb blasts, which is still happening throughout the world at Mumbai and Hyderabad and wherever the places are there. Which has created Pakistan, which has created Bangladesh. Everything was the blessings of the divide and rule policy. So we have driven them, the British. British have been totally driven away. Now 1857 is over and we have crossed one of centuries. But still we are saying that, for example, if there is a scorpion which bites you, it will go away. But the pain will also go with the scorpion or not. It will not go. It will, through its sting, instill inside you the painful vinam, which must be now totally mitigated and extirpated by a capable physician, by a medical suggestion and practice. Now what we have done is, 1947 has driven only the scorpion, it has not driven the poison out of the socialism. That is what I want to say now. It has created lot of people, lot of people in the society. Now we want to have lot of people like that. I have told in one conference about terrorism and patriotism, why terrorism is that is fruitful and patriotism does not work out. I told terrorists, they preach terrorism from their heart and they really work for it. That is why it is happening. Patriotism, they just speak and advertise and advise, so it is not happening. The intensity of the terrorist form to install and to permeate and to propagate terrorism, instinctive, equipotential commitment, dedication and contribution is not with the patriots. Such a people sitting inside a place, we have to create volunteers who must go to the sub-rural, rural, suburban, tribal areas, areas of violence, areas of that is sentimental eruption, areas of caste discriminations, areas of racial discrimination, areas of suppression, areas of poverty and power of wealth analysis. These type of different abnormal as well as the informal structures, pernicious structures, they must be put as a map. What is there in putting a map or graph with Jammu, Kashmir, Gujarat, then Pakistan, other things? That is not a map to be put now. That is too late. We have to put a map. With Indian map, we have to put and mark it with colors and demarcation that it is an area of drought, it is an area of flood, it is an area of mineral wealth, it is an area of paucity, it is an area of illiteracy, it is for the infant mortality rate that is intensified, it is for female forticide and infanticide. Such a map must be put by the Aikya Bharati, which is the real Aikya Bharati. Put a map and present the same before me when I am attending the next function, if you invite. So now I have to conclude just with the three questions and simple answers. Number one, normally it must occur in all minds. Number one, what is the message today? Number one, we have to create a problem analysis and mapping, just as I have already told, and how, whether it is equal or more than the situation of 1857, it must be first finalized. Number one. Number two, persons like Jhansi Rani, it has been told in the Shastras, Yoga Brashto Abhidayate. If somebody dies, he died with Jai Hind. Somebody dies with their inquisitiveness unquenched, with the mission of their life unfulfilled, those people will be born again. And number one. Number two, such people who fight for the nation and leaves the soul, they reach Chandraloka and great planets, great celestial level planets. What is the role of the departed people who participated in the freedom struggle? Still they live in the minds of people as inspiration, number one. Number two, they must have taken number of births, because somebody who really commits, nobly commits themselves for the nation, till they see that the nation is flourished, till they see that the brothers, the fellow brothers are in happy mood, real happy mood. Not this momentary happiness out of media, entertainment, other things. Real happy mood out of tranquility and prosperity, they will be continuously taking birth. They may be from us, they may be above us, they may be from us, they may be somewhere outside or inside. We cannot just see those things with our limited mamsa chakshu fleshy eyes. It needs a super descriptive para vision. So they are still with us, giving us courage. What is courage and bravery? Courage and bravery, it does not require success. What is courage and bravery? Courage and bravery, it shows your commitment and unshakable dedication, disobedience to any unhealthy or unruly elements. That is known as disobedience to unruly elements. Nanameyam tu kasyachit. I won't surrender myself to such elements. That type of commitment and disobedience to great people and disobedience strongly against unworthy elements is courage and bravery. Whether they have fought and succeeded or not is a second question. So even though they have not succeeded, you know that Janaki did not succeed at all. Just as Karna was totally betrayed by his chariot, she was betrayed by her horse. Moreover, the people, his father was hanged and executed by the British. And moreover, the British, they rule, they continue to rule for one more century. But still, whatever the commitment that they made, the disobedience, that is bravery and courage. So wherever you succeed or not, don't obey for any unruly elements. Whether it may be from your cousin brothers or brothers. Nowadays the world is very different. You need not put a battalion, army and other things. There are two other ways. Cultural infiltration and trade agreement. To rule a country means to dominate. To dominate a country, they need not utilize their power of military or at the cost of losing the lives of their own soldiers also and also spending millions of dollars. They do not do now. Now they have done lot of things like Indo-nuclear impact, MNC company, American trade company. Like through trade, we can create an expectation in the economy. I have told one thing with the External Affairs Secretary. Any growing country, how it will spoil the developing country, I have given a very good example. They will pose as if they have made $300 million of investment in nuclear power or in weapons or arsenals. They will pose. They could have done for at least $30 million or it may be even a full show. And seeing this, the developing countries also want to dress like developed countries. It is imitation is there, na? Pseudo imitation. It is just like something that is, it is said to be the cat's imitation of the tiger. Like this, developing countries by getting loan from IMF and the World Bank or even grown countries like France, Germany and US, UK, etc. They will develop their military thing without considering about the agriculture, health sciences, education and other development. By making these people totally liable and responsible for the debts, those companies, those major power blocks, those nations and their represented companies will root in our country and they will destroy our economy. Even though now our budget is 55% destroyed by international power agencies, 45% only by us. So now also we are having the same rule in a very cheap, elegant, majestic, smart manner. The same thing is advised. How to get liberation from this? How to get real independence that we have? And finally, I want to say something. Somebody asked me a question. How many temples are there in the land? How many sadhus were there? How many great people were there? Where those people they have gone? What about their power? What about their commitment? What about their spirituality? Where it has gone at the time of the Muslim invasion, British colonization? I have already told in yesterday's lecture, belief is different from power. Who believes in wealth more than the rich person? The poor person. A poor man believes in wealth more than the rich, but he believes and anticipates our dreams, whereas the rich person, he has a materialized process and having the power of wealth in his hand. So believe in God for our own benefits, either Ishta Prapti or Anishta Nivar, either to ward off our evils or God as a cow from which we can milk all of our benefits. That is the belief for our development. It is not for the development of our nation or for the contribution to God himself. So now whatever we are having, just as by friction, ancient days we produced fire. Like that, we are all stones. If we are dry and somebody could make a friction, the inner spark, it can be scintillated, which can grow into a radiant, brilliant and effulgent blazing fire which will ward off the total evils of the society, making our country once more the torch bearer or the lighthouse or the guide light for the whole globe. Also ourselves to be the patrons of the enlightened tradition of the whole cosmic history. I wish that it should happen and it must be made possible only by continuous seminars and organizing such conferences and workshops and spreading the message in regional languages to various people and also conducting competition. They are studying about unwanted things, about studying about a recent politician, somebody who is not worthy to be thought at all. Even if he is thought, we must take bath. Such people are now read great reverence. So that must go away. Such people, worshipable people, and